Hello students, welcome back. In the previous video, we learned what is an election. How do we elect a class counselor? We also learned what is a democracy. In today's video, we will learn how elections are held in India. Before we proceed further, let us quickly recall. What is an election? The system of choosing or electing our leaders is known as election. Now let us see what is a democracy. A country in which governments are chosen through elections in which the people vote is called a democracy. India is a country which is located in South Asia. It is the second most populated country in the world and seventh largest country according to area and the largest democratic country in the world. Now, India is divided into 28 states and 9 union territories. Since India is a big country, the governments are functioning at different levels. Types of governments. Union government, which is also called as central government. This government is responsible to handle the administrative work of the entire country. Next we have state government. Since India is divided into 28 states, each state has their own government. And the next is local government, which takes care of cities and villages. So each city and village has a government for its local needs. The citizens of India choose their government. Students, but that does not mean that you can vote since you all are very young. So when can you vote? A person is eligible to vote if he or she, that means you need to be citizen of India. You need to complete 18 years of age. Once you complete 18 years of age, a person needs to be registered as a voter in the electoral roll. Now, what is an electoral roll? It is a special list which consists the name of the citizens who have completed 18 years of age. Once the name is registered, they get a voter ID card. So this is a voter ID card. This is how it looks. Here comes the picture of the citizen and the other details like name, father's name, the gender, date of birth and the address at the back. A voter ID card, also known as the elector's photo identity card, the abbreviation is EPIC, is a photo identity card that is issued by the Election Commission of India to all individuals who are eligible to vote. So it is very important for every voter to carry their identity card, that is voter ID card, for casting their vote on election day. It is not easy to conduct the elections. All elections need a lot of planning and organizing. In our country, a body called Election Commission of India has been set up to organize and plan the elections in the country. The Election Commission of India was established in 1950. It is located in New Delhi. The election commission decides the election dates, holds election, provides all kind of information related to election, and announces results of the election. So it is the responsibility of the election commission to see to that the elections are held in a fair and peaceful manner. Elections are held once in 5 years. There are different political parties in India. Now, what do you mean by political party? A political party is a group of people who have same ideas about how a government should work. Each political party has an election symbol that represents their political party. These are some of the famous national political parties of India. BJP, Bharatiya Janata Party. This is the election symbol of BJP. INC, Indian National Congress. BSP, Bahujan Samaj Party. NCP, Nationalist Congress Party. CPI, Communist Party of India. TMC, All India Tirunamul Congress. So these are few political parties of India. As I said, India is a huge country. For elections, India is divided into many smaller parts. Each part is called constituency. Now, how this constituency or each part is formed? It is formed based on the population and not based on area. There are 543 constituencies in India, each electing one member. So the different political parties select their candidates for each constituency. Before the election, the nominated candidates ask the people to vote for them. Now, how do they do this? They do this through poster, through meeting called rally, through speech, advertisement, and so on. These help people decide which candidate in their constituency they would like to vote for. The first election took place in 1951-52. Since then, the elections have been held regularly to elect the government to run the country. After the first election that was held in 1951 and 52, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru became the first Prime Minister of India. He was the Prime Minister from 1947 to 1964. And the first President of India was Dr. Rajendra Prasad from 1950 to 1962. On the election day, people go to polling booth. Now, what do you mean by polling booth? A polling booth is a place where people go to vote in an election. So people go to the polling booth with their voter's ID card. After entering the booth, they need to show their voter's ID card. Here, one finger of each voter is marked with ink that cannot be rubbed off. Now, why is it done so? The ink is very important as it ensures that nobody can try to vote twice. It is a means to keep an eye on those people who might try to cheat in an election. The booth has electronic voting machine, which is also known as EVM. So this is an electronic voting machine. It is a device, electronic device for recording votes. There are total 16 buttons on this EVM. The voter can press the button next to the candidate's name whom they wish to vote for. Earlier, voting was done using ballot sheet paper. Nowadays, they are using EVM machine. This machine brings the election results in a very short time. The government does not control the election commission. That means the government cannot play any role during the process of election. The election commission collects all the EVMs after the votes have been cast by the voters. The votes are counted and the results are declared. The candidate who gets the maximum numbers of votes in a constituency is elected. The party with maximum number of winning candidates forms the new government. So students, today we learnt what is an election, the process of election, and the importance of choosing the right leaders in an election. Thank you.